that may have gotten written up by the operator or identified in the fuel station. The driver's going to stop right here, go to the maintenance foreman, let him know what's wrong with the bus. He'll look at it, triage it, determine, is it okay? Should I schedule this bus to come in tomorrow? Is it critical? Is it long, you know, long brakes or hard steering that has to be taken care of right away? And if we have an open lift, we'll put it on a lift if he thinks it's going to get worked soon. If not, it'll get backed up onto the defect line for later on in the day or the following day.
Back on Monday. lights. Those are the black boxes. I'll open up one of the black boxes and come across another one again. The kits basically have all the parts that we need to do the general overhaul. So this way you don't gotta run to the stock room. The parts are next to the bus and that increases production. So we're gonna work on that sometime during the week and hopefully get it back up on the road again.
Problems with buses like this, the parts are hard to come by. It's very time consuming to find parts. So that's one of the reasons why we try, anytime we find parts for stuff like this, we'll gather up everything we can and just hold it. So we can keep it going. So we want to keep it as original as possible.
I believe this is a 1948 GMC. Four motors and trannies, undercarriages in preparation for the program work. Bus 5879. And it's getting a reline, so it's getting a brake job only. It's a disc brake bus. Not necessarily. Once again, has to do funding that costs $100.
On mileage too.
These particular buses, the engines failed, and that's where they hit.
This is all the
back to the landing. This is an 04 bus. On this particular bus, it needs an engine, but on this bus, we take the whole package out as opposed to the bus right next to it, we just take the engine out. You can't get the engine out of that, but you pull the whole cradle out. This one, we can't pull the engine out individually. That's where we do it out. All right, and granted, if you paint, we have four booths which are capable of painting 60-foot buses, otherwise known as Artec buses. We can also paint small buses because the booth's big enough. Black.
Overhead, you'll see these harnesses. This is to put the bus numbers on top of the roof. Like if you ever had a building and you look down, you see the bus numbers. The only way to do it is you have to climb up on some high ladders, and the maintainer will hook up a harness so he can't pull up, and he'll peel off the decals and put new decals on. Just watch your step as you're walking through. It's a little narrow and there's poles. So if you're taking pictures, make sure you watch where you're walking. So you can see all the marks there. The black is going to be marked up. So everything will be taped on. Then the two men will go in there and they will paint blue on the whole side of the bus. You can see the black one. People were asking us about the black. This is where the black is. That's what we're going to ask for the detail. The blue stripe usually is right here. You can see a little imaginary line. Usually runs across here. In the front, if you look at the corner, you can actually see the blue. So a bus will come in. All the body work get done. It'll get washed and then they'll mask it up. And basically, what they mask is all the paper around the windows, the lights, the markers, the wheels, anything else that we need. Roll down the curtain and you just tape the edges, and that's how it reminds you. Because the first time you try to make the turn, you have to tape them. So we make little curtains and we would roll them down and just tape them when it's supposed to go. Same thing with the window, if you notice. You'll see that the window squared off because we cut it. We make a curtain, the driver brings it in, drop it down. When he's got to move to the next level, we cut it again, we fold it up. Like a pleat.
Basically an Excel program. So reading across, you can tell whether the bus got a heavy SO or not, whether it's a priority for this week or it's next week's buses. Also, you see whether or not we locked down and tagged out the batteries. So yes or no, I don't know, you're not going to be able to see it. Then comes the bus number, the location, what data came in, how many hours of operation we've got applied to that bus. And over here, we'll tell you what's left to be done in various states and form. That's not the only one. We got another one. This is one, this is called a production report, and you got a floor booking. The floor booking will have a similar information, where the bus is located, where the bus came from, how many hours got spent on it, location, whether or not the heavy SO is done. So that's another piece of paper. And then for the end of the week, how many buses actually got out the door? It's a production-based facility. Unlike a depot where they gotta make pullouts every day, I gotta make a production goal every week. So my production goal is supposed to be between 6 and 6.5. So if you notice, I put out 4. So that means next week I gotta put out 5, possibly 6, maybe even 7 for next week in order to stay with production goal. You also notice we do other work here. We've done relines, we've done structural repairs, AC conversions, we do AC conversions here, and then engines over here. Yeah, engines are over here. You got program engines, and you got miscellaneous engines. So the red engines are part of the program. With the Artix, with the blown engines, they're miscellaneous. So they're not part of the program. That's hit or miss whether they blow up or not. So they fall under miscellaneous. So for last week, we put out 28 buses in 5 days. Downstairs is totally separate. It's my own entity up in here. We don't have nothing to do with the depot. We can't help them out. Yo, I need a favor. All right, bring it up. I'll help you out. But for them to make pullouts, I have nothing to do with their pullouts. I have nothing to do with their scheduled operations, and they have nothing to do with my stuff. Everything about the bus is easy except for the bodywork. The bodywork, because it's all rivets, is a monster. But when you drive it in the snow, it doesn't come back broken. And made in America, General Motors Corporation built this whole bus, every nut and bolt, by Americans, for Americans.
Yay!
And where is it built?
Detroit.
No, New York.
Pontiac, Michigan.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Close.
This is a 6B71.
Hammond. Flat.
Wow. All the noise is coming your way.
All the noise. Half of my hearing loss is from these buses. And when this shop, a building like this, had 6 or 8 working at once, if you don't have hearing protection, it's a long time.
Back then,
nobody had it. Long time. All right, everybody, enjoy your site.
of surplus material in 207.
Oh, yeah.
It was a ridiculous amount of crap. It was a big warehouse in 207. I think they moved down to Coney Island.
Yeah.
But it was really dirty there. I carried up five doors up like flights of stairs, the entire R32 doors. It was ridiculous. Yeah, someone bought five R32 doors and I had to bubble wrap them and get them ready for shipping. It was ridiculous.
I can imagine. And is it true that they don't let you pick things up if you don't want it shipped? I heard that you had to be an MTA employee if you wanted to pick something up.
But I think they'll even like get like a freight company to come do it on your behalf.
Yeah.
It wouldn't like come out.
It was a weird.
Yeah.
I bought one of those Express Bus dollar bill pamphlets.
I used to go in there when I was a little kid.
Oh, yeah.
I forgot RJ Avenue, middle of